Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 10.7. In number one, we're asked to solve the following equations and list the answers which lie between 0 and 2 pi. So anytime we're given something like this, I make a quick note. There's only one trig function here, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to isolate that trig function, get it by itself. So that's the first order of business. So here I'm going to add 1 to both sides. This gives me 2 sine 2x equals 1. Then I'm going to divide both sides by 2. And this gets me the sine of 2x equals 1 half. So now mentally I think, okay, I've got the sine of something equal to 1 half. So where's that happen? Well, that happens at pi over 6 or at 5 pi over 6. And then to capture all the solutions, I have to add multiples of 2 pi. And that's going to capture all the coterminal angles. Like so. So I come back to here then. And the sine of something is 1 half. So I know that something, the argument of the trig function there, 2x, is either equal to pi over 6 plus 2 pi k. Or the argument of the trig function is equal to 5 pi over 6 plus 2 pi k, where k is an integer. So to solve, I'm going to divide both sides by 2. And dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by 1 half. So I'm going to multiply both sides by a half. And the same thing over here. And so I make sure that I distribute that through to both of these terms. That's a common mistake to forget to do that. And so I get x equals 5 pi over 12 plus pi k, or x equals 5 pi over 12. Oh, excuse me. This is just pi over 12. Got ahead of myself. Pi over 12 plus pi k, or x equals 5 pi over 12 plus pi k, where k is any integer. All right, so that's the solve part. And now we got to find the answers which lie in the interval 0, including 0, up to but not including 2 pi. And so at this point, we just go through the various values for k and see which ones fit. Since we've got pi over 12s here, it's convenient for us to think of 0. Well, clearly that's 0 pi over 12. And 2 pi, well, that's 24 pi over 12. And since I'm adding multiples of pi, remember pi is 12 pi over 12. So this is just going to help us as we go through to determine which ones lie between 0 and 2 pi. Okay, so in the interval 0 to 2 pi, what am I going to get? Well, when k equals 0, I get pi over 12. That's certainly between 0 pi over 12 and 24 pi over 12. If I let k equals 1, I'm adding pi, which is 12 pi over 12. That gives me 13 pi over 12. If I go with negative 1, then I'm subtracting, and I get a negative 11 pi over 12, which I discard because I want to be bigger than or equal to 0. So I don't need to bother checking any more negatives. If I plug 2 in, then I'm adding pi over 12 plus 24 pi over 12, and that's more than 2 pi. So the two answers I get from this family are pi over 12 and 13 pi over 12. I move to this family. I plug in k equals 0, I get 5 pi over 12. I plug in k equals 1, I get 5 pi over 12 plus 12 pi over 12. That gives me 17 pi over 12, which is between 0 and 2 pi. If I try negative 1 or 2, I'm going to get outside that range. And so here are the answers that lie between 0 and 2 pi. Now, as we mentioned in class, you know, when the number of solutions to sine theta equals 1 half between 0 and 2 pi is 2. Okay, there's 2 answers there. The angular frequency here is 2. That means that this sine curve goes twice as fast as normal. The period's pi instead of 2 pi. And so therefore we do expect twice as many answers between 0 and 2 pi. So we expect four answers. So that's just a quick double check that we're getting the correct number of solutions. We could check these solutions by substituting them back in and simplifying. That'll do it for A.